We have several privets that have been planted ornamentally for many years in the United States that are now escaping into wild areas as an invasive plant. Some of these privets come from both Europe and Asia, although they all have some features in common. Privet has good shade tolerance, so we can expect to find it in forest understories pretty commonly. Privet has a rather bushy, thick form out in sunlight, but can be actually kind of leggy and sprangly in the shade with not real thick foliage and kind of elongated stems. The bark on privet has a tendency to be a light gray in color and relatively smooth. In the spring, privet has clusters of white flowers that are relatively small, and we may find it flowering either in sunlight or in shade. Privet bears berries that will be green in the summer, gradually turning to a darkish purple to black when they ripen in the fall. Another identification characteristic for privet are these spurs sticking out from the main stem that bear leaves. These can resemble thorns and may in some cases be pretty stout and actually feel like thorns if they're encountered. The very small kind of rank order leaves on the twigs of privet offer an opportunity for good diagnostics in the field. This can look to some extent like Asian bush honeysuckle, but typically the leaves are smaller and oftentimes held much denser and closer together. Privet has opposite leaf arrangement and relatively small elongated leaves. The leaves sometimes can be somewhat waxy on top. The stems of young privet plants are oftentimes coming out of the ground in very vertical and straight orientation. This can be compared to Asian bush honeysuckle, which oftentimes has an arching form and relatively larger leaves that are held further apart on the stems. The pith on the inside of the stems of privet is solid as compared to the pith in the insides of Asian bush honeysuckle, which is hollow. This can provide us one separating identification characteristic between these two invasive species. Privet can be controlled using a variety of different techniques. Small plants can be hand-pulled. However, be cautious about the spurs along the stems that can essentially penetrate the skin if grasped too hard. Foliar applications sometimes aren't as effective with privet, so it's recommended that you add additional surfactants and penetrants to herbicides like glyphosate or triclopyr to enhance efficacy. Cut stump treatments can be very effective against privet using both high concentrate glyphosate and triclopyr once the stems have been cut. Basal bark applications are also another option when controlling privet, particularly using triclopyr and a carrier oil like basal oil. If you're looking for additional information on woodland stewardship issues, be sure to check out the other videos in this series. Thanks for joining us for this video.